to take you on a tour of what it's like to play Campaign Petersburg. Specifically today, we're going to look at the toolbar. In later videos, we'll look at moving, melee, and firing. First, the toolbar. As you'll notice here, there are 70 toolbar buttons. You'll have to take my word for it unless you want to count them. And to some extent, they're color-coded. Generally speaking, red stands for unit action, blue for info dialogues, green for map displays, brown for unit displays. If we look at the buttons from left to right, you'll notice as you hover over them, what each button will do is displayed. And if there is a parenthesis, inside the parentheses is a hotkey. If you'll learn the buttons and the hotkeys, your gameplay will be more entertaining and you'll move more efficiently. So first, let's look at this first button on the upper left-hand corner, which is the next button. In simple terms, that simply means you're moving from one phase to another phase. For example, you would start out with Union Turn 1, which is the movement and firing. You hit the next button, it'll go to the melee phase. Hit it again, it'll go to the opposite player's turn, which is the, in this case, the Confederate turn. Now, if we move along here, you'll notice that the first one I want to show you in a little more detail is the Change Formation button. So if we were to select a unit, in this case the 2nd United States Sharpshooters, and select the Change Formation, you'll notice it goes from line of battle to column. Column's very useful for moving up along the roads, as you'll see. The next button, and we'll select a new stack here for this demonstration, let's say the 124th New York Regiment and then the 88th New York Regiment. Now you'll notice that they are facing more or less the Confederates. They have a movement of 12. If we move the counterclockwise, we have reduced their movement by 3 and it is now a 9. If you go to about face, another 3 has been expended. And if we go to counterclockwise, another 3 has been expended. Notice that each time I do that, the facing of the unit actually moves. Let's hit about face to start at where we were to begin with. And now you'll notice that we're in the same facing we started with at a movement of 0. Now if we move along here, I want to show you some more buttons here. I'm not going to show you them all to you, but I'm going to show you some of the ones that I think are important. So let's go to the objective button, which is this one here where I have my cursor, and there's a small white flag. When I click on it, you'll see the objectives displayed with the unit hexes and their value. This scenario only has one, but trust me, other scenarios have many more. Let's hit OK on that one. If we move along on this row here, we'll get to the Resolve Melee button. If we were in the melee phase and we had already initiated the troops to assault, then we would hit the Resolve Melee button, or you could use Control P, which is the hotkey. On the next row, on the left-hand side, is the plus and the minus. This again shows you how to change maps. So we are now currently in the standard 2D map. If I hit the plus sign, I go to the zoom out 3D, hit it again for the standard 3D. Hit the minus a couple times and we'll be back where we started from. Moving along, you'll see this little white map, which is the jump map. More useful in larger scenarios with big maps, because then you can see the entire map with all the units in very small squares. But you'll get a good strategic view if you use that. Labels, if you want to see the road names and buildings and farms and swamps, you hit labels to get rid of it. Just click it again. Moving along, you'll see the hex button. If you click on it, all the little hexes will appear. Some people like to look at that when they move so they know where they're moving and don't necessarily have to guess. Very important is the binoculars. Click on that and you'll see all the hexes that can be seen from the stack that you are currently in. Next, I think important will be the org. Very important for unit integrity. Then the next button. Hit the next unit button so that you can see where all the units that haven't moved yet. And finally, the crosshairs, which represents going into fire mode from movement mode and vice versa. Very important. We appreciate you listening to this video. Have a great day. Have fun playing Campaign Petersburg. Thank you.